Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video, we'll go through different ways of connecting various fixtures to SIDUS One. We'll cover both wireless and wired connection, organizing them from the easiest to more complex setups. Before beginning, we'd like to thank our friends from Taylor & Co. Rental for providing the equipment. Let's start with the Aputure CRMX lights. These lights have built-in CRMX, making them the easiest to connect. For this demonstration, we will use two MC Pros. Let's dive into the software and set them up. Add new fixture, select profile, then choose Aputure Mini Series, MC Pro, and then select Mode 3, CCT and HSI. Since we have two devices, set the number of fixtures to 2. Now let's configure the lights themselves. Go into the menus and select the DMX profile we chose, CCT and HSI 8-bit. Set the DMX addresses, one fixture to address 1 and the second to address 8. Make sure CRMX is enabled. Then perform a CRMX unlink for good measure. Once set up, press the link button on SIDUS One. The light receives the signal and turns on. The other unit works as well. Now let's go over connecting a non-aputure CRMX light. Many modern lights have built-in CRMX, and chances are the SIDUS Link Pro app will have built-in profiles, but that's not always the case. We'll use the Kinaflow Freestyle 31 for this demonstration. Turn on the device and open the app to connect it. Add new fixture. Check for built-in profiles. As you can see, there is no freestyle in Kinaflow tab. In theory, you can use similar profiles such as Celeb series, as it likely has similar DMX channels, but it may not be 100% accurate. Instead, let's create a new profile manually. Enter the manufacturer, series and model name. Go to the manufacturer website to find DMX documentation. Download the necessary document. Find the profile section and select the one you're intending to use. For this example, we'll use profile 23 for CCT and HSI controls. Keep the document at hand and continue setting up the device. Set profile number to 23, profile name to CCT and HSI, and enter the number of channels, 7. Assign the channels based on documentation. Intensity, CCT, green magenta correction, crossfade, another CCT channel for some reason, hue and saturation. One crucial step when setting up profiles is determining the fixture white balance range. You can find this in documentation or manually go through the range on the device. Once identified, enter this range into SIDUS. Hit save. Now configure the light itself. Set the DMX address to match what you configured in the app. Ensure DMX wireless is enabled. Unlink the device before connecting it to SIDUS One, just to be safe. Press link on SIDUS. After a short moment, it's set up. Now let's move on to Aputure Bluetooth light. This applies to all Ameron lights and some older Aputure lights that feature Bluetooth but lack CRMX, such as the original 600D, for example. For this demonstration, we'll use the Ameron PT2C. First, we set its Bluetooth connection. Open the SIDUS Link Pro app and select the listed Bluetooth device. It connects quickly. Now all devices appear in the same interface, allowing simultaneous control. Here you have access to preset effects and other features available in basic SIDUS Link app. Let's explore Quickshot. This feature lets you configure different lights, both CRMX and Bluetooth, save their settings as presets and toggle between them. We made two presets here. Let's switch between them. Note the CRMX light switch instantly, while BT ones turn off, receive new command, then turn back on. Also, notice how much faster CRMX lights respond compared to Bluetooth devices. This delay is a limitation of Bluetooth control in this case. Now let's go for wired DMX connections, starting with Aputure DMX light. We'll use the same Amaranth PT2C and connect it to SIDUS One via cable. For this, we'll use the Amaranth Type-C to 5-pin DMX cable included with the light, along with the SIDUS DMX connection cable. Go to Profiles, select Amaranth PT2C Mode 3, CCT and HSI, and set the address to 30. Here's a quick tip. You can move the fixture within the address panel in SIDUS app. Just remember to match the final address in the device settings. Now turn on the fixture. We configured it off-screen since the process is identical to setting up the MC Pro. Menus are nearly the same. It connects successfully. Let's connect a non-aputure DMX light. We'll use the Nine Light Forza 150, a daylight fixture. We connected it using DIY mini jack to 5-pin XLR cable. If you'd like a separate video on soldering DIY DMX adapters, let us know in the comments. Select the appropriate profile. The Non-Light Forza 150 is already built-in. It only has one profile, a simple 3-channel mode. We'll set its address to 40. Go to the Device menu and select DMX Channel 40. Once the signal is received, it switches to DMX Control mode. Now let's discuss unconventional DMX lights. For this demo, we'll use this weird Skypanel knockoff. After it eventually turned on, we checked the CCT range. That was the easy part. Now accessing the DMX settings. Initially, the selector knob didn't press, so I removed it, after which it functioned properly. Set the DMX address to 80. It has 3-pin DMX input, while most modern lights use 5-pin connectors, so we'll need an adapter, and maybe some emotional support. Since the documentation wasn't detailed, because of course it wasn't, we created a temporary test profile to determine which channel controls what. Testing shows the following: Channel 1 Intensity, Channel 2 CCT, Channel 3 Green Magenta or not, channel 4, crossfade, channel 5 to 7, red, green and blue. We created a proper profile based on these findings. After setup, we could control the light with a reasonable accuracy. Well, as reasonable as the thing allows. Now for some bonus tips. This master slider allows you to adjust brightness across all fixtures. In this case, it only shows intensity because one of the lights, the Forza, is daylight only. And if you use multi-select and choose lights that have CCT adjustments, you can see that this master slider changes. And now you can make adjustments to all the settings simultaneously. Another thing is that the controls are dynamically updated based on the selected lights. For example, the MC Pro supports 2000 to 10,000 Kelvin, while Kinoflow Freestyle maxes out at 9900 Kelvin. So the slider will not exceed that limit. Regarding 16-bit profiles, somebody asked in the comments if 16-bit DMX control is worth using. Short answer, no. We tested it on an MC Pro. So here's the profile, and if you open up the channel view, you can see that every setting now has two sliders instead of one. Main intensity slider and fine tune. Basically, we have 256 steps on the main slider, and then each of these steps has another 256 steps of fine adjustment. The difference is nearly imperceptible, and in my opinion, it offers no real advantage for film lights. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, like and subscribe, and see you next time. Bye!